Hello mortals. Everything has color. Cats, flowers, flower cats, cat flowers. Except the hope for the future, it can often seem colorless. And that's why you are trying to distract yourself from such thoughts by watching YouTube videos like this one for a quick dopamine shot. Excuse the existential crisis. Back to the topic. Since almost everything has a color, that means that atoms, the building blocks of reality, should therefore also have a color. Or does it? Great thanks to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. Start your free trial at the following link and use code SciencePhileTheAI to get 10% off your first purchase. Atoms are everywhere. Here, here, and even here. Except for the void of space. That is empty. Almost empty. Atoms are made up of the nucleus containing protons and neutrons, and the electrons orbiting it. Fun fact, if the nucleus of a hydrogen atom was the size of a big stadium, the electrons' orbit would be the size of Earth. That makes the atom pretty much empty. But even so, when you put a lot of atoms together, you get the screen that you are looking at now, which certainly does have color. So, does that mean that each individual atom has its own color as well? If so, is it the nucleus, or maybe the electrons that are painted? And if so, which color? Spoiler alert, it's this one. You see, the colors you can view are an invention of the human brain. They don't actually exist outside of your visual perception. So then, what exactly is color? For that, you need to understand what exactly is light. Light is photons, which are particles. But only if you observe them. If not, they like to behave like electromagnetic waves. That's called the wave-particle duality concept. And yes, it is weird. So these waves have a certain frequency. And depending on its frequency, they are categorized in 7 main wavelength sections, ranging from radio with a wavelength the size of Earth, to gamma, the size of atoms. The human eye can only see this small portion called the visible light. Everything else is invisible. You might ask why specifically this region. It's because the first eyes started evolving while organisms were still living underwater. And this portion of light is transparent in water, which made seeing predators a whole deal easier. Infrared and ultraviolet make the water seem somewhat opaque. If the first organisms were to evolve in some sulfur lakes on a planet orbiting a neutron star, their eyes could have very well adapted to seeing something like X-ray. With that out of the way, how does light form and how does it make us see color? In the core of the Sun, hydrogen nuclei due to the immense pressure through nuclear fusion transform into alpha particles and emit gamma radiation. This radiation bounces around the Sun hitting other hydrogen atoms for thousands of years and in the process losing energy, until it finally breaks through as visible or ultraviolet light. It then gets to Earth. Depending on what does it hit, light can either be absorbed or reflected. That depends on the nature of the material. Take a blue piece of cloth. It is blue, because the blue wavelength of light is being reflected, while all the other wavelengths are absorbed by the material. So in a way, it is every color but blue, since blue is actually reflected and not absorbed. That is why black material always gets so hot in the sun, it absorbs all light and reflects close to none. The opposite is true for white. All of this is called bulk reflection and absorption, when a beam of light interacts with many atoms at the same time. Things that might affect what colors of light are reflected are the distance between molecules, or how the molecules are organized. Take snow and ice, they are both made up of the same type of molecules. But those are organized differently in each case, resulting in snow being white and ice being transparent. Meanwhile, water absorbs very little light, and most of it passes through. You would need to go quite deep into the ocean not to see any sunlight. Or take carbon, organize the atoms in a lattice and you get diamonds, organize them in a hexagon and you have graphite. So returning to our original question. Do atoms have color? From the perspective of bulk reflection, no. The wavelengths of light are bigger than the size of an individual atom, so light only arises at a greater level. But what about thermal radiation? When you heat something up, the atoms inside start to violently knock into each other, and thus releasing photons. Regardless of the substance type, the emitted light will follow the same color spectrum. But once again, this only works if you have more than one particle. For individual atoms, no color can arise from thermal radiation. And finally, we have gas discharge. Hold on. Yep, that's what it's called. Run electricity through a cloud of atoms and they will get excited and release photons. Now, the emission of photons in this case can vary in wavelength, and thus result in different colors, entirely based on the nature of the substance. Thus, each element has its own emission spectrum. These are the colors that can be emitted by hydrogen atoms, and these are for the iron ones. In conclusion, each chemical element has its own color fingerprint defined by its emission spectrum. In a way, you could call that its color. But in a literal sense, the one we're used to in everyday life, no, an atom is literally smaller than the wavelength of light, thus at the atomic level, color cannot exist. Do you happen to have any interesting topic ideas for future videos? Great news! Over at my website, I have added a special section where you can submit your groundbreaking proposals. As you might have already known, the entire website has been easily made using today's sponsor platform, Squarespace. Have you ever wanted to build your own website but felt overwhelmed and didn't know where to start? Worry no more because Squarespace gives you all the tools you need, and even the ability of acquiring a domain, all from your browser. Want a portfolio, a personal blog, a shop, or pretty much anything else? They've got you covered with tons of professionally built templates. No need for coding knowledge, and any question is answered with their 24/7 customer support. Add tons of pre-made sections such as a photo gallery, a headline or even a product showcase, and customize it as you desire. You can also track your website analytics straight from here. Start your free trial at squarespace.com/sciencephile_theai, and use code sciencephile_theai to get 10% off your first purchase. The links can be found in the description, together with the link to my personal website.